National Anthem by students of the Francis Letson Primary School and the Territorial Song by students of the Ivan Dawson Primary School and Leonora Delville Primary School. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Let us pray. Father God, we give you thanks for this day that you have made. You are our God. You are our Father. You are our Creator. You have been the God who has helped us, Lord, in the years past, and the God whom we know will help us in the years to come. We just want to honor you, Lord God, for the celebration, for the life of the Honorable Lavity Stout, for what he has done for this territory. We know that, God, because of you, Lord, he was able to accomplish all that he has done. We do pray the same spirit of wisdom, the reverential fear of God that was upon him will also be, Lord God, given to those who are present and future leaders of this territory. We covet your presence. Thank you for the talents that will be showcased here this morning. We just pray that, God, as a people, you will unite our hearts, for you have blessed us with so much. Let the spirit of celebration and joy, God, preside over this entire celebration today. And we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen.
Strength and the power we overcame to restore the Virgin Islands pride. With all the beauty we devise a plan to maintain on the shape of this precious land. Educating our people is our goal and key to maintain our success of this territory. Oh, how red a tie your daughter. Boast your beauty, and your success is second to none. Breed and radiant are your hillsides, they replenish your hopes and pride. Oh, beautiful Virgin Island, your qualities can never be denied. Oh, beautiful Virgin Islands, your qualities can never be denied.
Thank you very much, beautiful Virgin Islands. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Premier and Minister of Finance, Dr. the Honorable Natalia D. Wheatley and Mrs. Wheatley. Deputy Premier and Minister for Communications and Works, Honorable Kai Reimer. Minister for Health and Social Development, Honorable Marlon Penn. Minister for Natural Resources and Labor, Honorable Melvin Turnbull. Deputy Governor, Mr. David Archer Jr. and Dr. Allison Flax Archer. Territorial Representative, Honorable Calvin Malone and Mrs. Malone. Cabinet Secretary, Ms. Sandra Ward. Financial Secretary, Mr. Jeremiah Fret. Former members of the House of Assembly present, other distinguished ladies and gentlemen, senior public officers, those of you joining us live in the auditorium here this morning in the Eileen L. Parsons Auditorium, those of you viewing us live on Facebook, a blessed good morning to you. This is a celebration. I say good morning. I am Carolyn Stout Igwe, Permanent Secretary in the Premier's Office, and it is my distinct pleasure to welcome you to the 23rd commemorative celebration for the late H. Laverty Stout. For those of you who might have seen other numbers in the past, the 27th and others above, we can count. We have gotten it right a couple years ago in terms of the numbers. Some persons were using the date of his death, but that was not when the celebrations began. Celebrations began in 2001, so we are at the 23rd, just in case you see something else different on Facebook. We are here grateful for the persons who willingly said yes, once asked, and those who will use a little prodding because they're doing something outside of the box. For the past month, we have been planning and preparing for this theatrical production here today. I want to salute the planning committee under the chairmanship of Dr. LaVonne Chalwell-Bruley. Since she's given the vote of thanks, she can't thank herself, so I will do the thanking right now. The members of the committee for their hard work over the past few months. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's celebration comes under the theme, Countryman Comes to Town, Keep the Vision Moving, in the form of drama, songs, poetry, music, and dance. Local talent will be on display today. As this is a production, the program will run unannounced. Just need to let you know that last night we had to make some decisions in order to ensure a smoother flow. So there are some adjustments for those of you who have a printed program. So following scenes 1 and 2, we will have the dance by the HLSCC Stingray dancers. And the Joy Samuel Fungi Band will follow scenes 3 and 4. Miss Toria Price will follow the Joy Samuel Fungi Band as we are trying to keep things moving. The program, the production begins when I leave this lectern. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to invite the Premier of the Virgin Islands, Dr. the Honorable Natalia D. Wheatley, to start a production. He is poet premier today. Premier to give us his poem, Where There Is No Vision, immediately followed by the commemorative choir singing the song, Write the Vision, and everything else will flow from thereafter. Thank you very much.
Good morning. Where there's no vision, the people perish. The leadership of Laverty, we really should cherish. He deserves credit for the way we've developed, the progress made, the prosperity we inherit. He gave the blueprint to erect a nation, which includes comprehensive education. Many auspicious occasions where he addressed the nation. A lay preacher preaching, God bless the nation. A great modernizer, standing ovation. He gave us roads and bridges for our transportation. Like a cutlass man chopping down vegetation, he cleared the path to our destination. In reflection of the man, I stand and pay homage. He gave us all a community college. Gave us scholarships to increase our knowledge, filled appetites for learning like our morning porridge. He developed tourism, putting green in our pockets. Now locals can own a nice villa or cottage. We were barefoot, now our nice shoes are polished. The BVI's belt has increased many notches. Where there's no vision, the people perish. The leadership of Laverty, we really should cherish. He deserves credit for the way that we developed, the progress made, the prosperity we inherit. Happy Laverty Stout Day.
The word of the Lord came to the watchman in Habakkuk 2. He said, write the vision and make it plain. He continued and said that the vision has not yet come, but soon it will be fulfilled. And this is the vision being fulfilled. Come on, choir. Write the vision.
Write the vision.
And make it plain.
Make it plain.
That they
and not faint.
Said though the vision,
is only for a while, it shall speak and not lie.
For if
the Lord said it, you can count on it. Never do just what He said.
Come on, we're going to take it from the top. It says, write the vision.
Write the vision.
And make it plain.
Make it plain. That they may run.
And never faint.
And not faint.
Said, though the vision.
Though the vision.
It's only.
It's only for a while.
It shall speak.
Would you join them and say, it is so.
It is so.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is so.
God will do.
God will do just what He said.
Come on, tell us. It is so.
It is so.
Yes.
Yes, it is so.
God will do.
God will do just what He
since I'm the narrator, I'm back. Today, we have come to celebrate the holiday in honor of the first Chief Minister of the Virgin Islands, H.L. Stout, who was born in Long Bay, Tortola, on 7th March, 1929. He grew up in an era when any village outside of Rotong was known as the country. And the BVI was ran by a group called the Rotong Elite. Coming into town as Chief Minister, he met with many challenges which he had to overcome, and eventually our history records him as one of the greatest leaders known to the Virgin Islands to date. Ladies and gentlemen, Cross and Dove Productions and the H.L. Stout Commemorative Committee present the skit, Countryman Comes to Town.
Leave your word. Yes, me to a heart. Oh, Master, speak thy servant here, waiting for thy grace.
Good morning, ma'am. My mother asks who is calling.
You're a nice little one. Tell her it am me. Tell her it am me, Cousin Catherine Buckland from Don Carabay. I have a bungle for her.
It's
Cousin Catherine, it's you.
Yes, ma'am.
It's so good to see you.
Good to see you. Lord, you're looking nice.
Come in, take a seat.
Yeah, I got this little thing for you.
Thank you, Mama. The Lord bless you.
Girl, you see these two knees here? Lord, I'm trying to knock me down. Let me sit down here. Well, you see what in there? Thank God
for another day. And you don't.
And not the land of the living. Yeah.
What you see, soak your two knees there. Let me see why you bring me here. A little flour, a little oats, some Miss Philbert.
I had just something, you know, from Duncan Thomas. I take out some and bring for you. I hope you don't mind that the package them done open, but I take out some of mine and I give you.
I mind. Mm-hmm. I was just here wondering why it is I'm cooking a little piece of cornfish I got in there tomorrow. God bless your mama.
You see? That's how the Lord does work. Anyway, let me ask you something there. That little boy you got there, that last little one, Lord, he is manageable.
Well, thank you.
Dally, he had me biting off my tongue trying to talk proper. I know you just slick all kind of name for your children, them. That's the one you call Orlando Newton?
No. That ain't Orlando Newton.
Oh.
Orlando Newton is the oldest one of the set.
Oh.
That little one is Hamilton Lavity.
Lord, where you find that one?
Well, when he born, my dear cousin Mary had come see us.
Oh.
And when she looked at him, she said he's going to be a special child.
Okay.
He's going to be a great man.
Oh.
So I don't pray every day that he lived to fulfill that calling.
I hear you, my child. Yes, he looked like he's going to be bloody manageable. I was trying to set a thing.
Well, I was trying my best to get the talking right.
Okay, well, I got to go back up Caribbean, you hear me?
I'm going to
try and make it. Yes. See you, take care.
Thank you for coming, Cousin Catherine.
Oh, such a sweet child. Thank you.
Levi, I don't miss a thing. But see, don't that blue egg fall, we're just going to drop shit.
Shoo, go for Jesus. Go, shoo, thank you.
Lavity, as a young boy, attended the Zion Hill Methodist School from infants to seventh standard. His father, Isaiah Stout, died in 1936 when Lavity was only 7 years. But the young lad suffered no psychological trauma as he was nurtured by his mother, Mrs. Idalia Stout, and older brothers, Orlando and Prince. He excelled in primary school and was one of the students who passed the seventh standard test to attend the senior school in 1943 in Rowtown, which later became the Virgin Islands Secondary School.
Let me fix you there. I'm so proud of you, Levi. The only sad part is your father ain't here to see you go. But when you go, please, I beg you, don't
Miss Dally.
Make me hang my head in shame.
Miss Dally!
Hey, cousin, how you doing?
I good, how you?
I ain't father name.
Levi, boy, you're looking good. Cousin Dally, well, I hear, and I come with it. Because you know me already when I hear a thing. I don't come good. So because he dressing up, so what happened? Oh, I know why thing. I hear that Levi, you passed to go high school. You is the first one from all the country, boy, to come go high school in tongue. Boy, you're going tongue. You got to mind your manners. You can't make we country people look shame. You hear what I say?
Yes, ma'am.
A few things I want you to do. I want you to study your lesson good.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. I want you to behave yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
You see respect? You see manners? It take you to the wall. Behave yourself. Study your lesson good. You hear?
Yes, ma'am.
Go in fair on name. The Lord bless you. Go in fair on name.
I hope you hear what your cousin say. Wise counsel. I'll tell you every day. But when you reach Rowtown, tell Cousin Catherine Gomes them and say howdy.
Yes, mother. You
remain
know.
Remain manageable and respectful.
Of course, you know I have always been obedient to you.
Taking your lesson. The lesson you learn today is what gonna help you tomorrow.
Yes, mom.
Be a good boy. Be a good boy. Okay, Cousin Dally. Be a good boy. Hell, everything.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh. when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. The heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up. One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. And a child, even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. The biggest weapon is to stay peaceful. We sing, our music is the cuts that we bleed through. Somewhere in the dream we had an epiphany. Now we right the wrongs in history. No one can win the war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day, when the glory comes,
Always pong Emily, watch out.
Good day, my people.
Good day.
Mr. Stowe. Good day. How friend Daddy?
She's not too bad. Thank you.
Okay. You said it.
So.
Larry, too. Where you are now?
I see you going up the garden quite often now.
That's your business?
Why you going up there in Takayat? Mind you don't go up there when he's there, no? Let me tell you what here. Maybe I'll say that Eloise said that she husband Ziki said that them was done by Johnny Shop talking about it in Tata said he don't want no naughty head boy for his daughter them. Because if we get naughty head boys, I'm going to get naughty head children.
You're going to get in trouble. Wait a minute, man.
That is old talk. Look, God's going to give all my children curly hair.
Oh, okay.
You know, compare it. Look, faith, hope, and love. And the greatest is love. I'm going up the garden.
Ah.
Mm. Clarity, clarity, Lord.
Listen, your hair talk.
Pure talk, boy.
Clarity young from morning. But since he get with a white man, what? He got a different accent. My God.
I don't know. I don't know.
But you know them say, ever since he get with a white man, he pumping up that country by to go down road down to power in politics.
What?
Jesus.
My God, Bella, what you say?
But he better remember them say tongue people must lead this country. Jesus.
Bad news for them.
Pina, you.
Me tell you, no, he could God one news.
You hearing all of these things?
Girl, this thing to talk.
Yeah?
All we gonna do is listen. Cause I know what.
Pali what? Politics? Mercy. I don't know, but he's still gone up there, but Tata yet. My I better talk to you, no?
Wait. That's all. That's all. What happened to you? Why you look so? That's all you always say, Thomas. Where you could get decent thing to put on. No. Look at you. Where you going, St. Thomas, a wasting time? Your shirt holy, your pants holy.
And my God, let me hold your back.
Because that's all making you shame.
Are you going to stop pounding millions around our pit?
Lord, shut your mouth, man. We talking about Mr. Larity, that country boy from Miss Dally.
Are you keep studying Larity and are you to go cook food for your husband? When I go down to sip some rum, I hope are your husband pong are you pong are you pong are you pong are yourself.
Who you talking about? Who husband go here too?
I know he talking to me.
No, I don't know. I know where he come from.
You see Larry, he's still gone up.
Look where Patty is going.
Still gone up by there.
Tata only catch him.
Well anyway. Tell me he talking about. But I gonna go home, you hear me? I gonna go home. You understand? I got work to do. So
yes.
I gonna go home.
So wait, you think you're gonna let me one here under this almond tree? I come home too.
It's hard.
Well, good morning, Mr. Larity. How are you?
Good morning, Miss Fade, eh? How's things?
We're all good. But you and I have been discussing politics throughout the Caribbean and the desire of the peoples to advance from the colonial system. What I believe will emerge here is a membership system with the addition of district seats. Now, as you know, the present government is run by the road town elite. And I think you should run for one of those district seats so that the voice of the countryside can be heard in the future development of this nation. I've watched you work diligently with me, A.D. Watts, and my company, rising from employee to foreman to top manager. And I believe that you have what it will take to give this nation what it needs at this time. You care passionately about this country. You love all people equally. And I believe that you will do very, very well. And I give you my full support.
Oh, so you sending me in the den to blow down people?
Well, I believe that with your influence, Laverty, the notion of the separation of town and country people will disappear forever. I must go now. But
thank
I
you.
Beg you, please, AD. Please give this matter serious consideration.
Thank you.
As indicated earlier, we had a switch in the program, so the next item that you will have will be the Fungi Band from the Joyce Samuel Primary School. Thank you, Joyce Samuel. We will move to The song stand by Miss Toria Price, the 2020 Gen Y Factor winner, and then scenes 5, 6, and 7 will flow.
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun, weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can, when I can, while I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Cause I'll fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, do you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. My behind to face.
Pickle, but what I noticed there, say. Why I say what I noticed, say.
It have a lecture done by Mr. Jimmy Donovan Sharp at 3 this afternoon. Almost a 10 husband, wife.
Jared, let me say, buddy. What are you saying? Well, tell everybody that coming on the road.
I ain't telling Mr. Soul, drinking my rum.
Boy, I say Mr. Laverty is having a lecture. A lecture.
You studying heat?
Fredo, you know how to cook your food on time. Bye.
It was hot. It was sweet.
What?
She did very well.
Oh, boy. This afternoon, them were down here by the tree talking about Lawity's stout and all kind of thing. And she had the gall to talk to me about my holy shot. I'd want your crack to blows and her upside down.
Jesus Christ, but that's only holy for two. Well, anyhow, the meeting about to start. Let's go.
Mm-mm. One more. Come, give me a cup. Mm-mm. One more. Hold your hand steady, man. Wrap me up.
Lord.
Come, this one here for the thing them that didn't do the thing. Let me go hear what Larry Tigger has said. Me, mine, and he, and that's true.
That last time I wear a holy shirt. That last time.
To allow greater district representation under the membership system. People have always been my business, so I have listened to all the people of the first district who have encouraged me to seek a seat in the Legislative Council as their representative. People like Mr. Alfred Cameron, Mr. Beta Robinson, Mr. Andrew Smith, and Mr. Clarence Smith.
Nisho.
And my dear brother, Bembe.
Bembe.
And my employer, Mr. A.D. White.
That's the problem. That's the problem.
Yeah, look, there's a white man.
That's the problem.
Yeah, I was right.
That's the problem.
All right, stop.
And so, I have heeded the call to seek an elected member to join in the leadership of this country, along with my dear brother from the Rotan area.
Them is a problem too.
Mr. Stout, you sit tying up there telling me how you going Rotan. You know that the Rotan people don't like country people. Where you going?
Oh, Jesus.
I listen to you, woman. Along with my mother, who have encouraged me and cheered me on to put my best foot forward to seek election to represent you in the first district.
All right, sir.
And on the other hand, I have also listened to tell people who have encouraged me to take this bold step, like Mr. Charles Georges, Mr. Osmond Bradford, Claudie Bra, and Mr. Walter Freeman.
You're starting a setup.
Do you sound right?
It has cemented my motto, which I coined from the book of Proverbs, chapter 29, verse 18.
Preach where that,
there's
no
vision, the people perish.
Yes. Amen.
If I don't hold the vision to be an effective leader in this country, it can never happen. Together, we must hold this vision to see the British Virgin Islands unite as one country. No more division, town and country people. Let me remind you, this will not be representation for the first district only, but representation for an opportunity to wake the sleeping beauty called the British Virgin Islands. Mm. And I call her name to be known all around the world in the most positive light. Mm. So I'm here today publicly declaring my candidacy, seeking election in the upcoming general election. Now, you're all aware that I will be running against the incumbent.
You're going to fight.
My apprenticeship teacher, Mr. Wilfred Smith.
Hey!
Rugudu.
But we're not enemies.
Yeah, right. Rugudu's that.
But it's been a long time I recognize that one enemy is too many. All I'm asking on election day, if you believe that I can be the best representative for this district, vote me. Me. If you believe my teacher, Mr. Smith, can continue to represent the first district, then vote him. Because he too loves this country.
Oh.
But not as nearly as much as I do.
You see, I'm not your kid.
Hey, he's talking.
Oh, God.
My dear mother, she raised me in the Methodist Church at Zion Hill. And it's the good teaching of that church that I shall take to guide me when I'm elected as a member of the Legislative Council. I beg you, as always, remember, at the end of the day, we all belong to the same district, and we must work together for the common good of the district and the better good of our country. Let me share you briefly some of my vision I have for the first district as well. Vision for the entire British Virgin Islands.
Brace yourself.
I have a vision that one day the people of the first district would not have to ride mule, passes for sale for Western to get to Rota.
What you say?
Talking.
What you say?
But there will be a highway stretching from the Cottage Hospital to French Whiskey.
What?
Riding in four-wheel vehicles.
What? How?
And
no donkey, no more mule.
The road by Coxie will be a thing of the past.
Listen, I heard a... That's sweet mouth coming.
Sweet mouth? You mind in here? You mind here?
Yeah.
All them things he get from that white man, Eddie Watts. Does he pumping him up to carry out on the point politics?
I give a man a chance.
All right, okay, we done.
Does he?
And I have a great vision that this is just the beginning of the British Virgin Islands can become when the entire country unites. Listen, starting election day.
Oh, okay.
Vote me, H.L. Stump, number 2 on your ballot. And send me.
What number you say?
Number 2.
Okay.
Number 2 on the ballot. And send your next representative to the council. I promised you, and I promised my mother, Idalia Stout, good kitchen,
Daddy
that
boy,
I shall
man.
Never disappoint you.
Daddy boy, yes.
Vote H.L. Stout on election day.
Good job. Yes.
We're going to see him.
I got work for you. I got work for you.
To preach. We're going to see.
Number two on the ballot. You got my vote.
I need to
go to Twitter. I don't want to hear Will, friend.
No, man.
Must pack my ballot on spoil?
Yes.
And so it was. Mr. Stout was successful as a representative for the 1st District in 1957 and also in the general elections of 1960 and 1963. And these years signal the early days of his political career as a representative for the 1st District and a member of the Legislative Council of the Virgin Islands.
Jesus, have mercy, Lord.
Get him white case you're running so far. For me, take a load off of these two niggas here.
Lord, I bruise
them. How you bruise
them? I bruise them, my two niggas here. Lord, have mercy. Anyway, I come tell you. I come to congratulate you. Let me win.
Oh, yes.
He win again. I tell you, he win, and he win again.
God is good. God will answer prayer.
Well, Daddy, I gotta tell you something else. You're not a Western woman. And some of them from in Colonel Bottom too.
Yeah, what them do?
Them say, mind them say, and not me say. Them say, from the very first time you went to vote, you were the first one there with your black parasol. And when you stick it in your parasol, a black cat jump out.
What you say? What is you say? Repeat what you say.
I say, them say, you were the first one there to vote. And when you stick in your black parasol, a black cat jump on. That was the magic.
Lord,
make Larity keep walking, keep winning.
What the stock on this you come tell me here today? Me, Dali?
Timmy said to
me. Me, Dali?
Timmy said.
I never see a cat cut yet. No, dip thee to hand in necromancy. You see thee to me here? Others be on them every day.
I believe you.
Praying for my children, guidance and protection. I ask Father God for a little extra for let me be car. You see that job you take on there? It ain't easy. And I pray that Father give you the strength and common sense to run the country.
Well, for my little boy, you know, he was sharp, so I sure he's still sharp. You keep on praying, you hear?
Black cat?
Yes, man, that's what I said. Don't take the people them on. You're not just them West, them people, we call them don't like you, but that's all right. He still win.
Yes, Father God, I just put my trust in.
Yes.
What am I mucking up my name with?
My dad trying. You can't stop people. Talk, they will talk, and talk, they must talk. But you just have a steady walk.
Well, you can put in a word for me.
Yes.
Only Father God.
Only Father God.
Wanico! Oh, Wanico! Ning! Tell Mr. Georges in Howard and Mr. Quickie and Glennie that are coming down for a meeting this morning to see them. Ning, tell them 12 o'clock are coming. I go and go see Mr. Glennie them because I want to understand. I want them to understand what take place with the last election. I go into that meeting because country people cannot lead town people. I ain't care what them say this morning. I come here to defend the future of my two children, them, me and Patrick. Ah, yes, sit down there. Sit down there. I'm going to defend our future here in Road Town. And don't let Patrick go to see the bell, you know. Because I put a crop of gloves on you when I come back. I see all them people from Rotong. Morning, Mr. Georges.
Morning.
I didn't know you still taking land to bury poor people. Because Sammy Coochie come this morning and he left a message to Gayo.
Okay.
He said he ain't feeling dead. And he ain't got no, and she have a chick not child. And he got to bury her. And he said, he ain't got the money either. So you're going to got to trust him, the board, and the gray cloth, and the silver handle them to make the coffin. But anyway, he said, Phil, he got 3 acres of land. But don't take all that land now, you know. You got to leave some for the next generation, because I don't understand how land could equal the price of coffin. Anyway, morning, I gotta talk to them other men here.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Howard.
Good morning, Miss Lou.
I come to talk to all of you this morning. And Mr. Creaky, I see you broke down that little old shop you had there. And you're going to put up one-way glass. You ain't afraid them Tamon tree by poke or rock in it for you? Teen every style you see out there. You must bring hair in Tatola. Mine. And Mr. Glennie.
Morning, Miss Lou.
Why your head so shiny? What you put in it? Dixie Peach? Or Serena Brelentina? But anyway, I come this morning to get this meeting with all you. Because I want to know if all you understand what happened in the last election. Conrad formed the United Party with 7 members. And 4 of them get in. And Conrad lost his seat. Conrad lost his seat. And the party elected that smooth talking gentleman from Long Bay named Mr. Larity to be the chief minister of our country. He gone with the other 4 members from the country. Mr. T.B. Letsom, Mr. Larity, and Mr. Iwan Dawson, all countrymen. And them gonna be the ministers here in running our country. I want to know what you got to say about this, Mr. Georges. Because they're the last of we town people. They're gonna be the last of we town people. Countrymen coming to rule Road Town. I want to hear what you got to say, Mr. Georges. I want to hear what you got to say.
Well, you said it right. The countryman must lead a country. So you must give him a chance.
Hey, are you? Well, give you a chance. When you hear the ang song, you're going to know.
What say you, Howard?
Miss Lou, he's a good Methodist.
Hey, are
they? He has been representing well so far. Perhaps it's about time that we all unite instead of bringing divide among our people.
What Methodist got to do with this? Keep the church out of politics.
Also, he's been renting one of my buildings for some of those government offices.
Are you here there? All Howard studying is money to put in his suitcase. And we here in Rotong about to suffer because countrymen coming to town and that will be the end of Rotong.
What say you, Henry?
His mother is a decent lady. She raised him well. And he is pitched with character and good graces.
I hear he got grace, yes.
But we must give him a chance to lead. He also comes by the business and he always checks upon me. We have to give him a chance to lead.
Because he got like a sweet mouth. That's why he always coming to check EA quickie.
What you say, Glennie?
Well, what do you wish me to say now? Well, I love the dear hearts and gentle people of my country.
You always like it, dear hearts and gentle people.
And I must consider Mr. Stout one of those dear hearts. We've been working together since 1957, from the time when this country was nothing. And whenever we travel together, he's always pointing out to me what would be good for the BVI.
But you're missing the point. We about to lose Road Tongue, and all I am doing is sitting down.
But Miss Lou, you might not be happy to hear it, but it is time that we give him a chance to lead.
Are you trying to convince me to give you a chance to lead? But let me tell her, you know, if he ever slip up, we uptown people in them country by, we coming to pay he a visit. We gonna pay he a visit. Anyway, I going. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day, Miss Lou.
I'm going to tell everybody up Main Street, what are you down here doing? I am about to let we lose Road Tongue. I can't understand these men, you know. It look like women gonna got to run this country. Safi. Them saw from head to toe. I'm going to tell everybody that we are about to lose Road Town because a countryman has come to town. going to tell everybody up Main Street.
Don't worry.
What are your tongue people she'll want come to around. Do?
Just give us some time.
Let me tell you something now. Who in there? Who in the boathouse? Renisha. Renisha said to all it will be under rum. I say, Renisha, tell them that a countryman has come to Road Town. I say, I'm going to tell everybody who I meet that a countryman has come to town. Who else in there? Inga? Inga? You're in there? What jump doing peeping out through your window? What jump doing peeping out through your window? The police them cross nowadays. And them going to take his DNA. And them going to say what he ain't do to you. I say, man, Patrick, let me go up tongue. Let me go up tongue. Juanico, man, don't tell me nothing this morning. Don't tell me nothing this morning. Don't tell me nothing this morning, because all of you from up the country together, all of you from up the country together, and I gonna let a countryman come to rule our road. Miss Adeline, Miss Adeline, you're in there. Miss Adeline, I went to a meeting with Granny them. And them bow to let us lose Road Town. Them bow to let us lose Road Town. But we're not going to lose Road Town by letting some countryman come to town.
As the program continues, we invite Dr. Richard Georges, Poet Laureate, President of the H. Laverty Stout Community College, to give his poem at this time, which will be followed by Miss Sasha Wintz.
Good morning. I haven't recovered yet, so give me a second. In the absence of a formal memorial to the late, great Hamilton Laverty Stout, it is my belief that the institution in which we stand and sit and enjoy today's production serves that purpose. So I'm a little salty because I had to follow Miss Stout. And then the premier decided to put back on his poet hat at the beginning. So I feel like my thunder is being diluted. But I will pick up on something that the poet premier said in his rendition about the hand that prepares the path. And this is a poem I'm going to read about legacy. And I think it's high time that we look at ourselves and think and ask, are we preparing that path for those that will come after us? The dedicated soul. An ode to the legacy of Hamilton Laverty Stout. To the dedicated soul who stood in the mangroves thick and muddy bared and saw column and arch and honest wood when to others only land appeared. We dare not mislay your vision revered. Memory concreted in indifferent slabs. Ourselves to tongue a word in praise, lest we forget the distant ground we stand on now. These columns bathed in sunlight, these arches all rain glazed. For in this rusted quarter of time, no better memorial still stands than these modest halls, these grassy lands. No monument was better designed than this noble investment in minds. To the dedicated soul who stood to face the sting of insult and slur, well displayed the passion of his blood. People knew what his convictions were. To you, good night, good night. Rest well, good sir. Thank you.
For you to hold, you can find.
Lord, let me go listen to the hometown news here on ZBVI.
Welcome to an exclusive interview with Chief Minister of the Virgin Islands, the Honorable H. Lavity Stout, with our news anchor, Mr. Dwight Pickering.
Good afternoon, listening audience and people of the British Virgin Islands. Today we have with us in the studio of ZBVI, the Chief Minister of the British Virgin Islands, Honorable H. Lavity Stout. Welcome and good to have you here today.
And I'm delighted to be here, Mr. Pickering.
And it is good to have you. Now, 5 days ago, after the election results on the 20th of February, 1995, the people of the British Virgin Islands have returned the Virgin Islands Party to power. And you would now be serving a total of 16 years as Chief Minister since 1967. Mr. Stout, what is the secret to your success?
This was a hard-fought election. The at-large system was introduced, which was nothing more than a plot to derail me. But the people have had their say, and their voices have been heard. The secret would have to be from doing the people's business and delivering the goods, representing the same district every time, living in the same district, and being available to the people day and night, rain or shine.
Well, Mr. Stout, your record is well laid out. And under your leadership as Chief Minister, you have been credited with improving the quality of education in the BVI. You added the Social Security scheme, improvement in tourism, building of roads, schools, clinics, even a central administration complex, and the general development of the BVI. Let me ask, have you ever met or have you been met with any challenges during the past 25 years of ministerial government?
I can recall two distinctly, but I will speak about them in the reverse order of happening. The latter would have been when I first proposed the idea of having a community college for my people. There were people who saw the vision initially and others who opposed from the start. I was sent a note one day by a prominent person of Rotang who felt that any college that was proposed could only produce graduates who could be termed as intellectual midgets. This did not derail me when I was also told I am taking all the Parakita Belan to educate other people's children. But I consider anyone who would attend our college as the leaders of tomorrow, our children. And the last one, which has been etched in my mind and which is probably etched in my DNA by now, is the positive action movement. I shudder each time I think of what nearly had been. I think they have a movie or something by now. You would probably have to watch it and learn more.
All right.
Mr. Pickering?
Yes.
Thank you for having me. I have an emergency call now.
And thank you so very much for coming on, even knowing that your schedule is so busy, Honorable Lavity Stout. Do enjoy the rest of your day.
You're welcome, Mr. Pickering.
Aye, boy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm. The police got Noel properly beat up. We had promised Lenny in Howard M that if he make a little slip up, we going for Mr. Stout. We going for Mr. Stout.
Be
Farrington.
Yeah. Wilfred Bob Coupo, you here?
I here.
We got Mr. Nibs.
Right here.
Oh, you see baby dummy?
Right here, right here.
Good.
Mm. What about Patsy?
I here. Just give me a chance, my fingernail pop off. I'm coming, I'm coming.
Ay, 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 Patsy, let me get that.
You got on your red lipstick.
Mm-hmm.
I say we're going down to see Mr. Stout. We're going to pay here with it. Because what we've been hearing all week is not good leadership.
Not at all.
Are you ready?
We're ready.
Ready. Ready.
We war back our tongue.
And we're backing down.
I said we war back our tongue.
And we're backing down.
I said we war back our tongue.
And we're backing down.
I said wake up, ski for we.
Our bills hell going see.
I said wake up, ski for we.
Our bills hell going see.
I said wake up, ski for we. Our tongue mundo going see. We war back, we come ski.
Our tool mundo by sea.
We take him back, we come ski.
Our big head by sea.
I said we take him back, we come ski.
Our tool mundo by sea.
We come ski for we.
For all eternity.
I said we come ski for we.
For all eternity.
We come ski for we.
For all eternity.
This is the positive action movement.
Amanda.
Power to the people.
Amanda.
Power to the people.
Amanda.
Power to the people. This is the positive action movement.
Mr. Stout.
Mr. Stout.
Come out. Promise in the street, Mr. Stout.
Mr. Stout.
Come out.
Come out. We war back. We come ski.
Mr. Stout.
I said we war back. We come ski.
A tool mundo by sea.
I said we taking back
it sound like
ski.
A positive action movement.
I said we got take back Wickomski.
A big head on sea.
Wickomski got to be for we.
It look like a whole lot for them. They got stick and sardine can. Mr. Stout, come.
Where Mr. Stout?
Come out.
I said bring on Hello. Mr. Stout.
Come out.
He say he coming, Mr. Stout.
Come out.
Them calling for you.
Mr. Stone, come on!
We do even.
Lord,
we take him back, we come ski.
The blood.
We don't.
Lord, the
move your head.
You any, are you down there?
I got some sab.
Jesus, please put it on there.
Yes, the sab.
Good.
It dry up the blood.
Okay, good.
I said, Mr. Stone, come out! Because we want back, we come ski.
Oh, this mundo by sea.
I say we take him back, we come ski.
For all eternity.
Because we come ski belong to we.
I tell you. Come out, sir.
Mr. Stout, Glenny, and how are them?
Mm-hmm.
Them try to convince me to give you a chance to lead. But what we've been hearing here in Rotong all week is not good leadership. The police have got Noel properly beat up.
Mm.
And they understand that you sign a lease to that man named Bates Hill for 199 years.
He do it.
199 years.
Yes.
To Foline. Wickomski in Anigada.
Yes.
And now that he done fully in Wickomski in Anigada, he done on Wickomski, bragging, saying how when he done with Wickomski, the monkey then gonna walk down by George A. Street and they pick up them gonna be
not here. Oh,
not here.
Not here. Not here.
Will be the day when all the Rotong monkey them stop eating ripe banana from the country people them.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And we gonna walk down Wickomski and we gonna eat every last one of them pick up.
Every last one.
Every last one. I say we walk back Wickomski.
Yes.
And we gonna tap back Wickomski.
Yes.
Mr. Stout. Noel is here. he wish to read to you. And we want you to listen to him. Listen to him. Because we come here in the name of Rotom people. Because we taken back Wickomski.
Good afternoon, Mrs.
Come
Hat again.
Stitches again, please.
Lord, I must have put on so much sab. Anyway.
Anyway.
Try read a speech here. Because we are on a mission. We are on a mission to take back Wickomski.
Good afternoon, Mr. Stone.
Good afternoon, Mr. Loy.
I have a statement and I wish to read it, please, sir.
Proceed, sir.
I was arrested while walking down Main Street for protesting against the lease that your government signed to give away the rights to the land for future generations of the Virgin Islands to a man who has already started to exhibit his true thoughts.
True, he's showing
of establishing an apartheid state here in Rotown.
Not here in Rotown.
The police has become rather violent in this country, barging into my home without a search warrant against my international fundamental rights of personal liberty, freedom of movement, and freedom of assembly and association.
We go arrest the police.
Forcing me to take medication against my will, stating that I was crazy and red.
Can you imagine?
Mr. Stout, while I was in cell 5,
yeah,
I understood that the police came and inject my car me pep in an effort to disturb my mental state.
You hear them police?
This is the manner now in which subjects of my country appear to be living under police state.
No more police state. No police state.
Mr. Stout, the handwriting is on the wall as to what our country can become if the Englishman, Mr. Bates Hill, can walk into our country, adopt the same policy as the Englishman Cecil Rhodes did when he walked into Africa in the South Zambezi land.
Can you
and
imagine?
Rename the people's land to Rhodesia after him.
Okay. You hear that? That's what I'm trying to do.
Mr. Stout, you have been taken. You have been took. You have been hoodwinked. While at least with a lease of 199 years and full rights to Wickomski, Mr. Basil, if he possessed the same colonial DNA as Mr. Rhodes did,
he got it.
He too can very well rename our childhood land, the land where we play in the blue waters just in front of what is now Rotong Wholesale.
Wickomski.
Just outside of Rotong.
Same Wickomski.
Who knows what he can call it? Perhaps Bates Kingdom?
Not here! Not here! Not here! Not here! Not here!
Not here!
Not here! Not in Rotong!
Not here!
My colleagues, Walter Lindy DeCastro.
Yes! Walter, stand up!
Miss Patsy Pickering.
Yes, yes!
Mr. Roosevelt Smith.
Present.
Yes. Mr. Vaughan Sarrington from right up there by the bung. Mr. Cromwell Nibs. Mr. Wilfred Smith, you here?
Yes!
And Mr. Glanville Blyden. All stand in solidarity here with me today. And I have Miss Lou, she right here.
Right,
and we all pledge not to move outside from this.
Can we
ask the British government to cancel this lease and revert Wickomski back to the people? There shall be no apartheid state in the British Virgin Islands.
None.
And I pledge my life to this, Mr. Stout. This situation brought back memories of what I had seen when I visited South Africa and Rhodesia.
Tell them.
The native people had to get passes to go through their own land.
Can you imagine?
How could this ever be right in a land where our ancestors already paid for these lands? With their sweat, their blood, and tears,
and uncompensated
today.
We ain't get a cent.
Not even a pot to pay.
Nothing.
Mr. Stout, I urge you and your government to let us right this wrong.
Yes.
By reversing this lease and giving the land of Wickamskee to the people of the British Virgin Islands.
Yes.
The son, not S-O-N, S-U-N. The sun shall not set on so glorious a moment when the people of the British Virgin Islands can walk freely, invest in their country, and once again take possession of their land.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Mr. Stout, I thank you for listening to us and trust that these words will ring deep within you, because I speak not only of myself,
no,
but have gained courage from our ancestors who are ever present and cheering us on.
Yes.
May it please you, sir, and God bless these beautiful Virgin Islands.
And Mr. Stout, we want no oiling with this letter that got to go up to England.
No Santa.
We need no one, Santa. I say we gain your 30 days and return to the people.
Not even a
with
second.
A word to return Wickamskee and Anigada to the people of the British Virgin Islands.
Amanda!
Power to the people!
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 Mrs. Harrigan, Mr. Lloyd, I feel your pain. And I feel...
You're sure you feel my pain?
And I promise, all of you that I will go and I will seek the British government assistance so that I can get this matter resolved and get this property back in the hands of the BVI Islanders. I guarantee you that this will take place. And let me say something here. And now, I did not sign that lease.
You were there.
I did not sign that lease.
Then who signed it?
Where the proof?
The administrator, Martin Staveley, signed that lease.
And you sit down there in Exco and let them sign something. No, and you know what them sign it?
You was led astray.
You are a human. You were there.
I did not sign that lease.
Anyway,
30 days and not
I'm going to work on your behalf with the British government to get back Wickamskee and Anigada.
Anyway,
guarantee.
We say no Santarin.
30 days.
If you can't fly up that message to England, send a telex. Send a telex. I said because we want back Wickamskee.
Amanda.
We're taking back Wickamskee. We're going to take back Wickamskee.
Amanda.
For all our people. We're going to take it back. We're taking back Wickamskee. You guys, take a lot of energy.
Feel good. Thank
my
you, man.
My people.
That was nice.
The greatest issue that I had in my reign as Chief Minister of the British Virgin Islands.
Ladies and gentlemen, the countryman who came to town was a representative of the 1st District from 1957 to 1995. He held the post as chief minister for more than 16 years until its death in 1995. On this national holiday, we thank God for his faithful leadership. Let us not grow weary as we continue to build on the vision that H.L. Stout had for his beloved British Virgin Islands. Long live the Virgin Islands, as our forefathers envisioned it, and as we propel it.
After days and nights of writing, days and nights of practice, minutes to set up and seconds to deliver and execute. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the cast of the skit, Countryman Comes to Town. Miss Dally, Miss Gwendolyn Rubain, Young Laverty, Mr. Caleb Stout. Cousin Bucklin, Miss Sandra Herbert. Cousin Feeney, Miss Laverne Blyden. Cousin Ellick, Mr. Jacob Edwards. Mr. DeSalle, Mr. Dwayne Frett. Mr. Pickle or Mr. O'Neill, Mr. Sonyal Pickering. Mr. A.D. Watts, Mr. Phil Aspinall. Mr. Georges, Dr. Albert Thompkins. Mr. Penn, Mr. Jeremy Hodge. Mr. Creaky and one of the Tamman Tree Boys, Mr. Aaron Parallon. Mr. Fonseca, Mr. Mohammed Tarabay. Mr. Noel, Mr. Cecil Hodge. Miss Patsy, Miss Cheryl Boy. The Tamman Tree Gang, Mr. Art Christopher, Mr. Lucien Stout, Mr. Alvin Martin, Miss Alma Maduro. Narrator, Mrs. Carolyn Stout Igwe. Our stage manager, Mr. Kyle Ricketts. May and Patrick, Olana Glasgow, and Javian Javion Stout. Mr. H.L. Stout, Mr. Melvin Stout. And our playwright and director playing the character of Miss Harrigan, Virgin Islands cultural icon, let's hear it for Miss Janice Arlene Stout.
Yeah.
That you continue to listen for his guidance and his direction as we continue to work for a better Virgin Islands. We are winding down, ladies and gentlemen. We have two final items. The choir is going to come back to encourage us to press. And then Mr. Jeremy Vanderpool will give us the final selection. And that will be followed by the vote of thanks by the chair of this committee, this year's planning committee, Dr. Lavon Chalwell-Bruley. Thank you.
I'm pressing on to reach. Everything's gonna be alright. pleasant good afternoon. A few reminders before I get into the vote of thanks. There will be a rebroadcasting of the H. Laverty Stout State Funeral on Facebook at 4 p.m. today. In keeping with our celebrations, the Virgin Islands Institute of Studies has commenced a project to produce fact books on the territory's chief ministers and premiers in an effort to educate our students. The first fact book will feature H. Laverty Stout and will be released later this month. Further information will follow. The Greek orator and statesman Demosthenes once said, "Small opportunities are often the beginnings of great enterprises." Today is yet another day of opportunity. And by all demonstrated in today's performance, we can safely conclude that H. Laverty Stout believed in creating opportunities where to most they appeared to be none, or that the challenges were too great to be dealt with successfully. It is also fair to conclude that this 2023 celebration activity was a great success. A number of persons have contributed in many different ways to make this event successful, with presentations which created a relaxing, enjoyable, teaching, learning environment. And as such, we owe much gratitude to the members of the steering committee whose ideas, advice, knowledge of the visionary leader, special contacts, and camaraderie of willingness to respect differences of opinions aligned to enable us to accomplish our goal as evidenced today. The playwright, Miss Jenny Stout, penned and directed the account of the countryman's journey to town, which highlighted H. Laverty Stout's determination to succeed by overcoming many obstacles. Miss Stout, we are beyond grateful. We sincerely applaud your gift of playwriter and your willingness to use it for this activity, as we could not have done it without your significant contribution of Countryman Comes to Town. Not forgetting the members of the cast who took time from busy schedules to execute their roles, making this play a success, and by extension, the success of this year's celebration. We express our appreciation for your time and dedication. And if you are able, could you please stand and give a collective applause to Miss Stout and the cast one more time. Thank you. Dr. Georges, president of H. Laverty Stout Community College, and his staff allowed us to use this venue, which I must say added much needed structure and significance to today's program. Now, they were very generous, and we stress our appreciation. The professional excellence extended to us by the staff and technicians of the Eileen L. Parsons Auditorium was exemplary. We thank you. To the government of the Virgin Islands, who made it possible for us to set aside a day to reflect on and honor the legacy of H. Laverty Stout's love for the people of these beloved Virgin Islands, we say thank you. Our expressions of appreciation would not be complete without recognizing the excellent renditions offered by Dr. the Honorable Natalia Wheatley, Dr. Richard Georges, Mr. Raya Price, Ms. Sasha Wins, students and teachers of Leonora Delville, Francis Litsum, and Ivan Dawson Primary Schools, HLSCC Stingray Dancers, Mr. Jeremy Vanterpool, and H.L. Stout Commemorative Choir. Excellent. It is simple. They were excellent. Dr. Joycelyn Hout, our greatest and deepest appreciation for invoking the presence of God in today's proceedings. I must extend appreciation to Reverend Dr. Keith B. Lewis, Superintendent of the Methodist Church, and his staff, and the pastor and congregation of the Zion Hill Methodist Church for working so diligently with us and allowing us to play significant roles in yesterday's church service. A special thank you is extended to Permanent Secretary Carolyn Stout Igwe, our encourager, our motivator, and I must say, our very own Energizer Bunny. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Acting Permanent Secretary Smith Maduro and the staff of Premier's office, Dr. Arlene T. Penn and Ms. Matthews. Dr. Connie George, Chief Education Officer, I want to express my appreciation to you for your generosity in allowing two dedicated members of your staff, Mrs. Hyder Selwood and Mrs. Afia Smith, to assist whenever called to execute usher duties. I'm forever indebted. We value the hard work and dedication of the Chief Information Officer and staff of GIS for the marketing strategies employed in getting this event out there and ensuring that persons unable to join us physically could still witness this production. To the media, kindly accept our gratitude. Now, to you, our physical audience, as well as those viewers online, we sincerely appreciate your support for taking a moment today to forget the fact that it's a holiday away from work, away from school, to spend a little time to, as James Taylor's song sings, shed a little light on love on behalf of H. Laverty Stout for his insight, wisdom, and dedication to challenge the obstacles and pursue his visions, stretching the limits of our traditions and going forging the way forward. Thank you for participating in this manner. Thank you for attending. Now, if I inadvertently missed anyone, know that we appreciate your role. We appreciate you. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the day.